Well, you are, Billie. Hello, welcome to another video. My name's Dan, aka Lucent Music, and today I'm going to be reacting to When We Fall Asleep, Where Do We Go by Billie Eilish. So let's do it. In my opinion, this was like one of the coolest albums to come out last year. I haven't listened to this album in ages, so I thought, how about we rediscover it through means of a reaction video? So yeah, so today I'm going to be re-reacting to this album. What do you think of that name? Is re-reaction okay? Like, write in the comments if you've got any better ideas. So like everybody in the world, I have an Instagram. It's at singsongdan. It should be coming up on the screen. I do a bunch of like behind the scenes stuff along with just like my normal day-to-day life. Shall we get started? I think we shall. Duh. Right, so this is track one. We'll go from this into Bad Guy. What is an Invisalign? Like, comment below, let me know what an actual Invisalign is. I don't know what that is. It's the American thing, I'm sure. Got a white shirt in. I love the harmonies in this section. They're so precise and delicate. Bruises on both my knees. What has she been doing? So you're a tough guy. Duh. It's so different, this song. I think that's probably why it was just so big, was because it's so unique. It's like unlike anything else you've ever heard, isn't it? It's like my favorite bit. I love kind of like how she's like actively trying to come across as this, as the bad guy. I think that like there's like, you don't really hear that from women in music much, do you? There's so much interesting production on this song. It's so spooky. It's so cool. It's like a different song. I'm the bad guy. Duh. So I love, like, so the story of this song is kind of unlike anything else you kind of hear. Like, she's talking about, like, bigging herself up as this bad guy to other people, but I think there's something tongue-in-cheek about it. I don't think she's actually this person. It's kind of a bit of a middle finger up to everybody saying, yeah, I'm a young girl. Yeah, I'm like, what, she's like 18 or whatever. Yeah, I'm young and I'm a woman, but that doesn't mean I can't be everything you can be, you know? There's something quite rebellious about it. Let's go on to the next song, which is Zanny. I guess this is, Zanny is like that, there's like a drug, isn't there, in America? It's like an antidepressant or something, isn't it? I don't know. Must be missing something. There's something so amazingly intimate about the vocals. Too intoxicated to be scared. It's dangerous, isn't it? She sounds like she's at a dinner party, doesn't it? Wow. So much like super distorted stuff. So dry, like the vocals are just like so close. It's, yeah, it's really cool, really intimate, isn't it? Oh, it's beautiful. It's so quiet. I love it. It's so cool. So it's about like, I guess, kind of like the dangers of drugs and alcohol. Maybe she's talking about how she doesn't fit in with these kind of, with the social stuff going on around her, you know? Like, she feels like she's different to everybody else, I think. She says she can't afford to lose someone. Maybe she's worried about how drugs and alcohol could affect her friends and she might lose somebody because of it. It's just so like, I must be missing. I feel like I have to whisper. Too intoxicated to be scared. Wow. Beautiful. I just love it. Oh my god, it's so stunning, isn't it? It's just so quiet. She's so brave to like make music that's just so quiet, you know? That's just like so fascinating, that song. She just sounds so different to everybody else out there, doesn't she? It's like, who else would have like a song that's so full of like production, like there's like dining going on in the background and super distorted bass, and then just take all of it away? Like there isn't any, it's not, it's like there's no reverb or no anything on her voice. It's just like super quiet and totally dry with these delicate little harmonies. Like it's almost pretty, you know? Oh, there's something so fascinating about it. Oh, it's really, really cool. In terms of like the storyline, like it sounds as if she's really like worried about the effect that like Zanny, the drug and alcohol, and how that could affect her and her friends around her. Like too intoxicated to be scared. Like there's something so dangerous about that, isn't it? And it sounds as if like when she's in the secondhand smoke, she's not the one smoking, still just drinking canned Coke. Again, she's not partaking in the kind of unhealthy stuff that's going on around her. It doesn't sound like she's worried about not fitting in with the people around her, more that she's just observing them and thinking, you know, what are you doing with your life? There's something super melancholy and super sad about that last section. Maybe she's worried for her generation, I don't know. It's really fascinating stuff. Oh, it's so cool. Okay, let's go on to You Should See Me in a Crown. Oh God, I love that. It's like a scythe, isn't it? Being pulled on the floor. That drop is so cool. She does this like super quiet stuff. She kind of pulls you in and then she goes boom. And it's like, whoa. I think this kind of feels like a song that's like to her detractors, to the people who underestimate her. It's like, look what I could do with the power. Look what I could do with the crown. I just love how dry the vocals are. It's so cool. If you think I'm pretty, you should see me in a crown. It's kind of like she's actively throwing off the expectations that are kind of put on her as a woman. Kind of seizing power and being a powerful person. Despite the fact that people think she's pretty, you know, she's like, nah. I don't want that. The thing is, like, in terms of like genre, like this isn't the kind of music that I usually like listen to, but like, I don't know, it's just something so fascinating and so intriguing about it that like, I love it, it's so cool. Yeah, there's something really powerful about that song. It really sounds as if she's kind of saying, if you think I'm pretty, if you think I'm like beautiful and like feminine, then you should see me in a crown, because I would take this power and I watch them drop one by one. What you think of me isn't who I am. There's certain expectations that are put on her as a young woman, and she's just throwing them off and turning it on its head and saying, don't put those on me, because actually if you saw me in a crown, then I would be terrorizing people. it's really cool. So this is All the Good Girls Go to Hell. It's like her demon, her Lucifer. All the good girls go to hell. I think it's kind of saying that like, no matter how you live your life, you're all going to hell anyway. So you may as well just do whatever the hell you want, innit? Maybe she feels like she has this dark streak, but it isn't reflected in the people around her. Her Lucifer, her demon, is lonely, you know? God herself. Even God herself has enemies. Like, it doesn't matter how good you are. Like, you know, there's still people out there who disagree with you. There's still people out there who, you know, are going to make you do bad things, you know. Do-do-do-do-do. So much stuff of her laughing in it. It's really funny. Do this, snowflake. Yeah, she's kind of saying like, if we're all going to hell anyway, what's the point in being good? Because actually it's only one person's interpretation of what good is anyway, you know? It all feels like a kind of a really rebellious way of kind of saying, be who you are, you know? And for Billie, that is like being a rebel and being like different and being dark and being moody. And she really says that with every single song. The songs sound like that, you know? It's really cool. I think my favorite song so far has got to be Zanny. I just love how like, how it can be dark and moody, but also really delicate and beautiful at the same time. Oh, next is Wish You Were Gay. I am, babe.
I don't feel so good, sick.
Look the other way. I wonder if she's writing from her own perspective here. Is Billie into girls? Dunno. Wish you were gay.
Is there a 12 step just for you?
Maybe there's a straight person that she has feelings for. I like that. That is there a 12 step just for you? Like the Alcoholics Anonymous thing. Like, how can I get over you? It's like an unrequited song, I guess. It's like she just wants to like be with this person, make it better for them. Orientation. I love the lyrics there. Like sonically they go from one side of the spectrum to the other so instantly. It's really cool. Right, and now I'm gonna Google, is Billie Eilish gay? Okay, right. So reading up on that, she says that actually, it literally means I wish he was gay so that he didn't like me for an actual reason, rather than the fact that he didn't like me just because it's me. So it is a song of unrequited love for a man. So she's not talking about her own sexual orientation. She just wishes that this guy had like a solid reason for not liking her, not just not liking her because it's her. It's almost like she wishes that he was gay so there was some protection for her ego, I guess. You know, I definitely relate to that. Like, I've had feelings for straight people before. And I think you're almost kind of like, it's always going to be a fantasy because you know that they're not going to be into you. So you're almost like protected. So you kind of live in it in a way. And it's so much harder when they are your preferred sexual orientation, because then you just have to come to terms with the fact that they just don't like you because you're not their type, which can be really difficult because that can really harm your ego and harm your self-confidence. But you've kind of just got to push past that, haven't you? Like, there are certain people who I think are like, you know, fairly good looking, or, you know, we're into similar stuff and we're both gay, but like, I wouldn't date them. It just doesn't feel right. I just don't like them in that way. And sometimes that's just the way it is. Next up is When the Party's Over. I've listened to this one quite a lot, actually. I really like this one. It's so beautiful. It's kind of almost feels like it belongs in a church, you know? Oh, so beautiful, this song. I love it. Sounds like it's after a breakup. Like a lie, say I like it like that, like it like that. There's a lot of self doubt. Call me friend, but keep me closer. Yeah. I think maybe this is referring to the like one-sided feelings she's had. She's saying like she could lie and say, you know, I'm independent, I'm, you know, not affected by this, put on a brave face, but it's not real. She's saying goodbye to this person. Oh, I love this. So she clearly doesn't really like being on her own, you know. Oh, I love that. I love that. It's just so beautiful. It's just so delicate and beautiful and heartfelt, and she manages to still keep the kind of like the kind of Billie Eilish-isms. Like, there's a lot of darkness to it, but it just manages to be so Like, she really lets her guard down with this song. I think a lot of the songs so far, she has the guard up, like she's the bad guy. She's got this kind of persona that she's kind of protecting herself with. And then this song just like takes that all away. And she says she could lie and say she likes it like that. She could lie and say that she's okay, but she's not. And it's like, it's just so heartbreaking. It's stunning. Oh, I love that. I really like that song. I'm going to add that to my like absolute favorites playlist. So next is 8. Ukulele. I hate a ukulele. I just find them so cheesy. But I do think that she's relying on that element of cheesy to create something here. I love how they just take away all the music. It's almost like she's a little kid at the beginning, and since she's kind of singing with the little kid now with the harmony. It's kind of like merging back into the normal voice. I don't know how they do that. It's so cool. Maybe all these songs about this unrequited love. Who am I to be in love when your love is never for me? There is something inherently selfish about having feelings for somebody. It's weird, isn't it? It's kind of how you react to those feelings, I think. But how are you supposed to do it when you look at me like I'm see-through, you know? You don't notice me. I don't know how you feel. Do you even feel anything? It's a really cool song. It's like she's doing a duet with like a... It's almost like a baby version of herself. She must have sung it in a lower key and then pitched it up. And it makes it sound like something childlike, you know? Yeah, it's really fascinating. I'm not sure why she's singing a duet with her younger self. Maybe it's because she sees herself as being immature. Maybe it's because she sees herself as having childish feelings for somebody who's not reciprocating. So this is My Strange Addiction.
No, Billy, I haven't done that dance since my wife died.
I don't know what that is. I'm gonna have to look up what that sample is. I think a lot of this is about like the feelings that she has for this other person. Yeah, maybe she's kind of comparing these feelings for somebody to like some kind of kink thing or something strange or and weird. Maybe she doesn't understand why she has these feelings for this person. Maybe it's just her digging through the feelings and trying to figure out why, you know? She kind of compares it to this self-destructive behavior, you know?
Did you like it? Did you like that?
Let's look up what the samples are in that. Oh, it's from The Office. So yeah, so reading about why they put in quotes from the Office, she talks about how her strange addiction is The Office, which is so random. I just love how it fits like rhythmically in with the song though. It's cool. It's almost like they're like she's having a back and forth with the people who are having that conversation in The Office. I really like how she compares having feelings for somebody, like unreciprocated feelings, presumably, and being addicted to a person that doesn't make sense for you and trying to dig through those feelings. It's quite an interesting take on that. I think that can be said for a lot of the songs on this album seem to be like topics that have been broached in music before, but she has an interesting perspective and puts an interesting twist on all of it, you know. It's really cool. Right, so next is Bury a Friend. Something so menacing about this, isn't there? Name of the album! It's like self-destructive behavior, isn't it? I wanna end me. They're like, the samples and the stuff in this track are so menacing and creepy, aren't they? Maybe it's a bit about being trapped in kind of self-destructive behavior. So dark. I don't know. I wonder what the line "bury a friend" is referring to. It's so like bleh. It feels like halfway between a horror soundtrack and a pop song, doesn't it? Maybe she kind of can't understand why this friend would associate with her. Maybe she feels like she's such a bad influence that like she might end up burying this friend. I'm not sure. I'm actually going to look that up. What is Berry a friend about? Oh, okay, this is different. So apparently Berry a friend is from the perspective of the monster under her bed. Huh. So I think the kind of the meaning of the song is pretty, like, mysterious. I don't think anyone really kind of has one idea of what it's actually about. But there's a lot of profound kind of questions that she asks herself. And maybe she feels like a monster. Or maybe if it is from the perspective of the monster under her bed, like, maybe that monster actually doesn't know why it's a monster, you know? Why are you scared of me? Why do you run from me? Maybe the monster under the bed doesn't really understand why it's a monster, you know? It's so cool anyway. Whatever it's going on, it's really cool. Right, so the next song is Ilo Milo, Ilo Milo. Oh yeah, I remember this one. It feels like she's really, like, confessing her fears to us, you know? She sounds very insecure in this song, telling people to lie to her just so she kind of has, like, a feeling of being protected. Maybe somebody did die, I'm not sure. Maybe she's worried about what she's gonna do to herself, and she's saying, like, someone needs to come and protect me, you know? Maybe she's just saying to them, like, I need you to come and look after me and tell me you love me, even though it's a lie. I just need the support, you know? It really does feel like she's confessing fears to us. Every song feels like a different fear that she's kind of confessing, in a way. It's so interesting, like, it's so different. It's difficult to decipher. What is it about something in the something? Next is Listen Before I Go. Maybe she thinks she's gonna die. She says, I wanna see the world before I go. Oh, it feels like she's been broken by somebody. Oh, so beautiful. Sounds like she's, like, contemplating ending it all, you know? So beautiful. It's just so quiet, and there's something really kind of almost like classic jazz about this, you know? So beautiful. I think she's really feeling like she's at the end of her tether with this person, that maybe she's spent so much time loving them and then not loving her back that she feels like it's all gonna end. Deja vu, leave me deja vu, yeah. Because you've done it before and you'll do it again. I f***ing love this. I just love all the tiny little background things you can hear that just give such texture to it. But it's none of it's in your face, it's all just so incidental, you know. It's just wonderful, it's so good. It's like a song written at the end of someone's life. It's just, but it doesn't feel pretentious. It just feels like broken. Maybe that's what the sirens are about. Maybe this person threw herself off the building. It's just like, I love all the kind of like the cinematic painting in that song, you know, like the sirens and the thunder and the city, and it's all like so evocative of, it almost feels like she's up there in the rain looking out over the city in this thunderstorm and just kind of thinking, you know, even if you did come back and try and save me, you'd just leave again and it's never going to happen and I can't live on like this. Oh God, it's just so good. It's so good. Oh, I love it. I love it. It's so good. Me. Right, that's also going to my absolute favourites playlist. If you want to check out my absolute favourites playlist, just follow me on Spotify. I have my own artist page and I put up a few featured playlists. If you want to check that out, go for it. Right, next we have I Love You. Now, this song, I think, came up on like Shuffle or something. I heard it before I listened to the full album and I loved it. I loved it. It's so beautiful. So let's just revel in it, shall we? It's just so like, the guitar is so beautiful. Maybe she's finally told this person the truth. She seems surprised by how she's been able to take her walls down, you know. Love it. It's just so sounds like she's on an airplane, doesn't it? Yeah, that's the airplane taking off and the announcements in the background. It's just so heartbreaking. A good lie. Yeah. Well, you are, Billy. Just like, I've heard this song before, but I don't think I've really listened to the lyrics as much. Maybe now this information's out in the open, their friendship can't go back to how it was before. And it's like, we could try and make a relationship out of it, but it's not real. It would be a lie. Maybe she feels sad for this other person. Because they're like trying to make her feel better about it. Oh, it's just so wonderfully done, isn't it? It's just so good. Even that, just that little, the ooh, you know, it's like, it's not like over. Done. It's just so delicate and so perfect. It's wonderful. That song is just so special. It sounds like there's a friend who's said to her, look, I love you, I have feelings for you. And it's almost like she can't say it back. It's not real. And like, she feels awful. And she knows that it took them a lot to actually get the courage to say this to her. And then she has to kind of say, you know, I'm sorry, I don't feel the same way. And like, this person is smiling to try and like kind of make her feel better. And it's like, they're both trying to make each other feel better, but they can't because it's just awful. Like, it's just a shit situation. And like, I can't take it back. It's already said, it's already out there. And maybe things can't go back to the way they were. And we could try and have a relationship, but it would be a lie. It's just, oh God, it's just so wonderful. Like, wow, what a special song. Re-listening to these songs, like actively re-listening to them, like as in this kind of as a reaction, you really like end up listening so much more closely. And that song, like, maybe I hadn't really listened to it closely enough because it's just so, so beautiful. And it really ties together all those like elements of like fragility and like an intimacy that she manages to put into her vocal performance and really makes the most of that and makes a song that is just so delicate and so haunting and so heartbreaking. It's wonderful. Like, and it's unlike anything else I've ever heard, you know. Shit, that song. Again, the Absolute Faves playlist is getting built up today. Right, let's go on to the last song. This is Goodbye. A fitting name for the final song of the album. Something very classic jazz about a lot of the harmonies and music that she uses, you know. It shouldn't work, but it does. I love it. Maybe it feels like she can't say anything else. She, like, is reusing the elements of previous songs to reusing all the melodies from previous songs, maybe almost to kind of say, that's all I have left to say. Yeah, it's just like, that song kind of feels like a weird finale, but really fitting at the same time, because it kind of merges together all the melodies of all the songs and the lyrics from the previous songs, maybe just to say, you know, goodbye to the listener. You know, it's as a way of kind of summing it all up, maybe just saying, this is what I have to say. And that's all I have to say. There's nothing else left to say. I'm so glad I re-listened to that, because I don't think I'd really kind of paid close enough attention when I first listened to it. It's just so unique. It's so different. I can't say more about it. It's just wonderful. Like, and for them to be so young and to be making music that's so, like, really is just so different and so brilliant. It's amazing. I love it. And there's certain songs on there that are really gonna go right up among my favorites ever. Like, I Love You is just stunning. It's like her and her brother have like taken all the elements of things that they're really good at, lyrics, production, and painting the story, but it's more than a sum of its parts. All these elements come together in a way that's so moving and so unique. It's just amazing. It's amazing. Beautiful. Yeah, I think, yeah, it's one of my favourite albums in a long, long time. Amazing. Ugh, God, Jesus Christ. Right, well, that's that. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed that reaction. Obviously, it's slightly different because I have heard the songs before, but I do think that, like, I still managed to get so much out of listening to it again. Let me know what you think of the video. Please post in the comments. Let me know what you think about it, and then, you know, maybe I'll do it again. There are a few albums out there that are, like, my favourites, and I would love to kind of dig into them as part of this channel. So, yeah, let me know what you think. Thanks so much for tuning in, and I guess I'll see you again soon. Right, bye!